we have got to open the place up, because remaining closed forever has its own cost in every sense of that word.
The state's release from lockdown at last laid out.
This is a very difficult balancing act.
The modelling underpinning the plan showing daily cases will soar, peaking at 4,500 by mid-December. And in January, the total number of deaths from Delta will reach 2,200.
These are sobering numbers. The notion of opening this place up really quickly at 70% or 60% or today, that simply cannot be done.
For lockdown-weary Victorians, it's a cautious exit. When the state hits 80% single doses, expected around September 26.
Melburnians will be able to go outside to catch up with friends and be involved in some of the outdoor activity that they have longed and craved and really missed.
October 5th, a gradual return to school, with Year 12s back on site, Years 1 and 2 and prep back part-time from October 18th.
A staggered reopening. It'll look different, but they'll be back in the classroom.
At 70% double doses, forecast around October 26.
Reasons to leave the home and the curfew will no longer be in place, so lockdown will be off.
For the fully vaxxed, life will start looking a bit more normal. Hospitality can open up, allowed to serve fully vaxxed diners outside.
In this 70 to 80 phase, there is a massive priority toward outdoor activity, because that is so much safer.
At 80% around November 5th.
That's our ultimate end point.
All retail will open and masks will only be mandatory inside. All students can return to school. Visitors to the home and indoor dining with limits return.
Regional Victoria and metropolitan Melbourne will be on the same set of rules.
Mandatory vaccinations for all authorised workers, teachers and childcare staff on the cards.
We are opening up, be in no doubt about that. And there will be no turning back.
Epidemiologist Professor Nancy Baxter joins us now. Professor, what do you think? Has Victoria got the balance right here?
Well, you know, we need to open up. And so at some point, we are going to have to accept that, you know, COVID is circulating. The question is how much COVID we're willing to allow to circulate and what kind of steps are we going to take to try to decrease the amount of people who are getting ill and going into hospital and dying of the disease. You know, I think what the Andrews government has done is when you're at 70% has really prioritized outdoor activity. So, you know, they say the lockdown's ending at 70%, but really there's not much that people can do because they can't really go into anywhere like a restaurant or anything like that. So trying to prioritize outdoor activity because we know the risk is less than, and then more freedoms at 80%. One of my main concerns is that, you know, most jurisdictions, when they've come out of lockdown, they've come out of lockdown when, you know, the cases and the numbers of people in hospital are very low. But when we look at the Burnett model, actually, when we start to get 70 and 80% of people vaccinated, we're actually going to have quite a few cases from this outbreak. And, you know, that's a concern because our hospital system will already be burdened. So I think the one thing that we can do as Melburnians is try to keep the numbers as low as we possibly can so they don't have to do any kind of pause and not allow us to continue with this roadmap as planned.
Professor, we're both Melburnians, and I'm assuming, like me, you got to experience your first bit of freedom yesterday because we were allowed to have a picnic. Do you think the Premier realises that having a picnic in Melbourne when it was about 8 degrees and wind whipping through was more of a punishment than a treat?
The picnic gods have not been shining on us, that's for sure. But I'm sure many people enjoyed the outdoors, and hopefully it accomplished what they wanted it to accomplish, which was to allow people a little bit of socialization, a little bit more freedom, because I think they were concerned people were starting to have guests over to their home, which is just a much more risky activity than meeting people outdoors.
There's such incredible fatigue in Victoria, but it was actually quite surprising to see Daniel Andrews lifting restrictions at 70% rather than 80, even though you can't go indoors and those things. But do you think that's all about giving some hope when New South Wales is going to be opening up around about that time because they should be hitting the 80% mark?
Well, I certainly think that New South Wales has kind of set the narrative and set the tone for what opening up looks like. I must say, though, that in the past week, Gladys has been kind of tempering her talk in terms of saying both things have to be under control on the ground, like hospitals can't be overwhelmed when they decide to open up at 70%. Having said that, things are really looking positive for New South Wales. My fingers and toes are crossed because hopefully we've reached the peak of the wave, which means that in, 7 to 10 days, hospitalizations are going to decrease because the cases have decreased. So maybe by the time they reach that 70%, they're actually going to be at a much better, they're in a much better place in terms of hospitalizations and ICU admissions. I mean, that's my real hope for New South Wales, that things are going to look much better than we thought they were going to look a month ago.
Professor Nancy Baxter, we always appreciate you adding your expertise to the show. Thanks for your time tonight.
Thank you.
From expert opinions to in-depth analysis and reporting, the Project YouTube brings you the biggest stories from Australia and around the globe. Hit the subscribe button now for news delivered straight to your feed.